season at Miami.
Games to play. We see a little bit of a younger starting lineup here tonight, so it seems like they are trying to, you know, get a little bit of a look at what they might be able to have next season. And like you said, RedHawks have had a little bit of a rough stretch recently, but so has Kent State. They're coming off two straight losses. Two teams here tonight looking to get back on track. Until the last two games had not allowed more than 70 points in conference all season. They did it the last two games. RedHawks hope to keep that trend going here today. Yeah, that's right. RedHawks not able to get a ton of separation there. Would like to see them get a little bit more motion going in that offense off ball to try and get a little bit of space, put up some good shots. Nice pick and roll between Ivy Wolf and Foster Walker. That'll work. Just couldn't get the shot to fall.
On the flip side, a little shooter Scott now racing up the floor, able to navigate through the traffic and now settle down. Top of the key, Davidson passes off. This is Wolf. Wolf drives across the court. And now goes back to Scott, who will settle near the logo. 13 to shoot. Scott crossing over with one hand with the battle. Hate to shoot, battle pushing off on the drive down the lane. That was floated off the glass too high. Rebound picked up by Young. Behind the back to the bench of the captain's timeline. And a handoff to Schumann. Schmidt triple teamed into the corner. Young able to navigate for a couple of Redhawks and draw the foul.
A personal foul whistled on the Redhawks, number 12, Katie Davidson. That's her first. The team's first.
On Katie Davidson for the Redhawks.
Reporting in for the Redhawks. Number 4, Vanessa Garrels, coming in for Eden Battle. And number 1, Maddie Gluse, in for Katie Davidson. At the line, shooting 2. For the Flashes, number 32, Hannah Young. For Kent State, number 0, Casey Santoro, number 16. Number 15, rather, Bridget Dunn. Number 20, Claire Kelly.
With possession under the basket. Inbound to the sky. This one back outside. Top of the key controlling his work. Should get back to Scott on the far side near the elbow. Wolf has it back now. 9 to shoot. Gluse kicks into the corner, three corner for Garrett. That one just off the iron. Rebound for the Flashers. This is Schumate turning up for it. Schumate with pass and gets back to Santoro here at set. Santoro, straight games off the bench for the Flashers. Flashers kicked into the game. They lock this one into the high pace for Flashers. Now it's kicked back outside. Three corner, Tom Flash is higher in the air. But it can be corralled by Blackford on the rebound. And the foul is called on the Redhawks and we'll see in sequence.
The personal foul on number 4, Vanessa Garrels of Miami. That's her first. The Redhawks, second. Coming in right now, number 25, Jada Duckett for the Hawks, replacing Tasia Foster Walker.
And let's go, defense! Here we go, Redhawks! Come on, and
move! Blackford, but she can't finish. Redhawks race up court. This is Wolf. Trying to get the Redhawks on the board. She does.
Field goal, Ivy Wolf.
Nice to see Wolf take the ball to the bucket on transition. She's had a Redhawks have had a little bit of a rough time getting the lid off the net so far. When they're moving slow, got to move fast if that's not going to work.
Quite a bit of time after the Redhawks took a while to find the board. That one just rolled off the rim on the contact and shot from Ivy Wolf. Out of bounds for the Golden Flashes.
Number 14, Lindsay Paul, comes back in for the Golden Flashes, replacing Nyla Blackford.
And Blackford will come out of the game for Kent State.
For Miami, reported in is number 32, Katie Richardson. For Jada Duckett.
For Miami, 6-1 freshman forward out of Zionsville, Indiana. Just come off the bench in the last 5 games, had 3 points in the last game. Against Buffalo on
three-point goal, Katie Schumann. Timeout, Miami.
Here's Kent State, a 9-point lead. That'll force the Miami.
Miami women's basketball is proud to join in the celebration of Black History Month.
Yeah, gotta love those media timeouts. I was a little confused because yesterday we did the men's game. It's 20-minute halves. I forgot that it's quarters in women's basketball. I was like, oh my God, we're already 5 minutes left in the first. This is crazy. Oh, really? Yeah. Gave them other things to think about.
Number four, Vanessa Garrels, her second. The third, team foul. Reporting in for Kent State, number 32, Hannah Young. For Miami, coming in number 10, Eden Battle, and number 32, Katie Richardson.
Three to five.
substitution, number 25, Jaden Duckett for Miami.
Tough play for Battle there. Good job by her to try and get to the rim. Just unable to get around that Kent State defender in the lane.
Coming in right now, number 5, Mariah Modkins. For Casey Santoro and the Flashers. Basket by Paul.
Six to go in the first quarter. Battle to the near side for Scott. Out of the fourth quarter, Ruth may have stepped out of bounds, and she did.
A few unforced errors here from the RedHawks early. That's not a recipe for success, especially against a team like Kent State. It's one of the best in the conference. Yeah, they have. Yeah, good to see Scott get to her pull-up. That's usually a recipe for success for Miami. I think when their offense is struggling like it is now, they're going to have to lean on Scott quite a bit, even more than normal.
Coming in for Kent State is number 14, Katie Shoemate, and number 15, Bridget Dunn. For the RedHawks, number 12, Katie Davidson, and number 32, Katie Richardson, reporting in. The foul is whistled on number 24, Peyton Scott. Her first. The fifth for the RedHawks. At the line shooting two, number 4, Nyla Blackford.
Smart play by Scott there to get her feet set when she saw that Kent State player was driving into the lane. That's a veteran play from a veteran player. I'm pretty impressed with Wolf's ball handling. A few times today, she's really wound around this Kent State defense and found her way to the rim somehow. She hasn't been able to really get those layups to fall, but if she ever does, she could be a pretty good offensive player for the RedHawks. Only a freshman.
Freshman guard, out of Minster, Ohio. She's been kind of that second player behind Scott is a three-pointer there is no good for him. Tied up on the court, now popped into the air, saved by Blackford into the arms of a Redhawk. That was Davidson. May have deflected on its way back into the court off the player on the Miami bench. So it'd be Miami ball. Blackford went into the second row of chairs to try and save that one, but hit a Miami player on the way back in. So
State's number 14, Katie Shoemate. The first. The team's second.
No longer a factor. Miami takes over. Carried up court by Wolf. Heavily marked up by Modkins. Now Wolf gets a screen to get around to her. Gets the pass back behind the unsuspecting Davidson. Another Miami turnover with just 8 seconds to go.
Oh, that's a really tough turnover for the Redhawks, kind of akin to if we were watching hockey, like a goal allowed in the last minute of a period. Really tough when you have a chance for that last shot. It's a chance to, you know, get ahead a little bit on the scoreboard, get an extra few points in the bank. Redhawks surrender that opportunity there with a little bit of a careless turnover.
So with 8 seconds to go, Kent State's now going to inbound from the top.
Also reporting in now, number 11, Sydney Watkins for Eden Battles.
Peyton Scott's going to come out as well as Ian Battle. 7 seconds to go. Inbound to Modkins. Modkins gets a screen. Moving toward the far side into the corner. Shoemate for 42.
At the end of the first quarter, the score remains Kent State 14, Miami 9.
Pretty good start for Todd Starkey's team.
All right, fans, right now it is time for Black History Month trivia. Now, the first person to meet our marketing representative down at the marketing table with the correct answer to this trivia question will win a prize pack. Listen up, because here is your...
LuQuest Polyjack Schmelzinger alongside, 14-9. The Golden Flashes lead Miami after 10 minutes of play. And Jack, it was kind of a tale of two parts, you could say, in that first quarter. This Kent State really jumped out. Kind of on top of the RedHawks for the first few minutes, but Miami settling into the game, and just a 5-point game now as we head into the second quarter.
Yeah, definitely a little bit of a more defensive-minded first quarter, or at least these teams weren't making a ton of shots on offense. We'll see if that keeps up here in the second.
Golden Flashes will start things off with possession and a block right away underneath the basket. Nice play there by Davidson, all ball. Now she'll try and transition, floats it off the glass. That's no good, but an offensive rebound from Miami. And prior to that, a foul is called on the ground.
The foul on Kent State, number zero, Casey Santoro.
It'll be on Casey Santoro of Kent State. That's her first personal.
Coming in
substitutions
right now for Miami, it's number three, Tayshia Foster Walker
and Eden Battle back into the game for the RedHawks. 9:44 to go in the second quarter. Scott gets the inbound from the near elbow. To the far side now, Watkins gives it right back to Scott. At the free throw line, Foster Walker to the far elbow, three-pointer. That is no good off the hands of Battle. Santoro gets the pass off the rebound. Thinking about the three-pointer there was Thal. Instead, she'll drive. Now it's kicked to the near side for Shoemate. Shoemate with a hop tries to turn around a shot, and that one just rolled over the rim and in.
Basket by Shoemate.
7 points for Katie Shoemate, leading scorer on this Kent State team. That was a bullet that was right at the hands of Battle. A foul was called at the same time.
Number 14, Katie Shoemate, her second.
It'll be on Shoemate, so that's her second
Flashes
personal.
Second. Number 32, Hannah Young comes
That'll
in.
That'll bring Hannah
Shoemate
Young into the
Flashes.
Game to replace Shoemate. So the RedHawks will have possession now with 19 to shoot. And Scott will control off the inbound. Hand off on the far side to Battle. Now back to Scott, open in the corner. Three-pointer, that one off the iron. Offensive rebound for Watkins. Second try, doesn't catch anything. And it's tipped out of bounds on the rebound off the hands of Kent State.
Really good, strong rebound from Watkins there. She put a nice power dribble down on the floor and brought it back up. I thought she was going to be able to put that one into the net. Just missed, but good for the RedHawks. They're able to get the possession for the inbound.
So nothing on the first two tries on this possession for Miami. Now maybe the third is the charm. Foster Walker down low for Wolf. Pulls back, mid-range jumper off the front of the rim, and now finally Golden Flashes will pick up a rebound. Young secures the loose ball. To the near side, Kelly faked the shot, drove down the baseline, but she lost control. Goes out of bounds, possession now to the RedHawks.
And that's a fifth turnover so far in this game already for Kent State. RedHawks, they're not really doing much for it with it, shooting only 4-for-17 from the field, but you have to think eventually they're going to start taking advantage of these opportunities that Flashes are giving them.
Kent State generally a pretty disciplined team, so certainly a little uncharacteristic to turn the ball over as much as they have, but like you said, Jack, not really punished too much through the first quarter. 7 to shoot on the RedHawks' side. Wolf will take it down and pass across for Scott off the glass and in. Wolf drove down the lane and found a wide open Peyton Scott after she drew the double team. Now some trouble on the other side for Kent State. The player goes crashing down. That's Santoro in front of the Miami bench. It'll be a foul on Miami.
The RedHawks first of the second quarter.
First team foul for the RedHawks here in the second. 7:55 to go. All the way to the near side, trying to wait on it was Thal. Now she'll turn this one around with the left hand, but it misses wide right. Out of bounds, and we're going to get a foul call on the RedHawks as there's a Kent player that fell down. And it'll be a timeout for Miami. Inbound here for Kelly. Can't find a target initially, but got it in the nick of time to Blackford at the free throw line. Kelly makes her way towards the middle and now dishes off for Thal. Thal ball had a pass tipped right back to her. Now she'll give it a try down the left lane. That one was blocked away. Second try now off the rim right side before it can be picked up by Scott. Tipped away from her by Blackford into the court side seats, but possession will stick with the Miami. Seven 30 to go, quarter number two. Kent State leading Miami by five, 16-11, our score. Red Hawks looking to snap a three-game losing streak that came into this one. Kent State continuing to be stingy on defense. That pass was tipped out of bounds by Kelly. Miami will have an inbound in front of the Kent State bench. Scott passes this one in for Wolf. Wolf gives for battle. Now inside, losing control initially was Fulton, but she was able to regain and get a shot off. It didn't go though. Saved from falling out of bounds there by Modkins, and now the Flash is racing the other way. Young, back for Modkins. She'll settle down top of the key. Gets around a screen. Didn't get her too much though. It'll be reverted to the far side now. Young drives and kicks. Three-point field goal good off the kick from Dunn.
Bridget Dunn,
the freshman out of Carmel, Indiana, shooting 40% from beyond the arc this year and knocks down a big one to put the Flashes in front by eight. Stutter there from Battle, and on the far side, that'll draw travel.
Number one, Maddie Gloose, and number 32, Katie Richardson. Come in for Tasia Foster-Walker and Tiana.
So a big three, and then an unforced error on the Redhawks' side. Gives Kent State a chance to potentially take the lead by double digits on this possession.
And Miami's only scored 2 points in the first three or so minutes of this period. The offense really has not gotten going yet.
And the Redhawks really struggle to find their legs in that first and kind of doing the same here in this second quarter. Good interior defense from the Redhawks there as they've kept Kent State outside thus far. Trying to change that as Young as she crosses back and forth, but still nothing. Kelly with eight to shoot, into the corner, getting around the pressure is Young, but she's blocked by a player for the Redhawks. That was Peyton Scott. Now it's taken away and passed up front to Ivy Wolf. Wolf tried to drive down the lane, but couldn't get anything. Calling for it underneath the basket was Clue. She was wide open, but Wolf did not see her. Wolf has it now at the logo. Makes her way towards the near elbow. Rolls off the screen, thought about the kick, instead just drove and threw it up at the basket, hit off the underside of the rim. Racing ahead is Modkins, cutting back with the left hand, that one off the rim, no good. Picked up by Clouse, Redhawks trying to work the transition game. Clouse all the way to the rack, that wasn't a great attempt off the left side glass. And that ball was out of bounds as it was in the hands of Richardson, whose momentum carried her out the baseline.
Yeah, Luke, like you said, not a great shot there. Redhawks really not using Peyton Scott very much. She's only taken three shots so far. In the games that I've watched this season, they really almost always run the offense through her. Kind of surprised they're not doing the same here tonight. I mean, it seems like we've had enough sample size of them not doing it to see it's not going to work. They're going to have to go to her at some point.
Exactly, Jack. Scott has been held to just 4 points in the early goings. Just hasn't had the ball in her hands a whole lot on the offensive side. Most of those duties have been saved for Ivy Wolf, who's kind of been the Redhawks quarterback, if you will, today. Redhawks do get a stop on the defensive side on this possession, though, as they'll force an errant pass out of bounds.
And for the first time in a while, they inbound to Scott,
yeah,
rather Scott's, than Wolf.
Scott's going to be the point guard on this possession. Setting up a potential screen in front of her is Richardson, and that'll open up a mid-range look for Scott. The pull-up jumper won't go, though. Rebound picked up by Dunn for the Golden Flashes. She pushes ahead. And on the far side, this is Thal. Back to the top of the key. Modkins for three. It's good.
Betrayed by Modkins.
Mariah Modkins, not a great three-point shooter necessarily, but a big one there, and the Flashes are up now by 11. Scott into the corner, open look for Battle for three, it's good. Big response from the Redhawks. Modkins trying to work around Scott, does so successfully, but now meets the mismatch in Clouse. She'll float this one down low. Now it's kicked back outside, ball in the hands of Bridget Dunn. Little give and go play, Dunn gets it again down low and one. Dunn gave it off to Thal and made a hard move toward the basket, got it right back through the contact, and got the roll on the layup. That'll bring it in one, but it will follow this media timeout. Back and forth through the past couple of minutes. Kent State leads by 10. 4:10 to go in the second quarter. 24-10. Golden Flashes will be back in a moment here on Red Hawk Radio. West Bojack, Schmelzinger alongside. 4:10 to go here in the second quarter. Kent State leading by 10, 24-14 our score. And Jack is going to this game at all. A lot of defense through the early parts, but more of a track meet the past 2 minutes or so.
Yeah, that's right. A lot of running all over the floor. And well, there still hasn't been a ton of points put up on the board by either team, but they're at least getting the ball moving. I think that we're going to see the RedHawks pick it up on offense a little bit here. Peyton Scott just needs to start taking some more shots.
Absolutely, and right as you mentioned it, Jack, you kind of spoke it into existence, if you will, with Scott getting the inbound a couple of possessions ago and putting up a shot. Out of the timeout, the free throw was good for the Golden Flashes, so the end one play complete for Bridget Dunn. So her first 3 points of the game. Now the RedHawks trying to do something offensively, build a little momentum. Scott, top of the key. Passes off for Kluse. We get a whistle and a foul away from the ball.
The foul committed by number 20, Claire Kelly, her first. The third to the Flashes.
It'll be the third team foul on the Flashes, and it'll bring an inbound on the baseline for Miami. Wolf will take it, and she'll pass outside for Battle. Scott controlling now. Back to Wolf on the near elbow. Bounce to Scott, top of the key. Battle. Gets it back on the far elbow. Now back to Scott on the near flank. Wolf gives to Scott. Fake the shot with three to shoot. She'll just have to pull up from mid-range, and that's money.
Nice little floater there from Scott. Only the best basketball players can make that work in a game. Peyton Scott, one of the best basketball players.
Yeah, Scott just found a tiny bit of separation, and that was all she needed, but a similar play on the flip side as Modkins knocks down the pull-up jumper. Scott jabs and now moves toward the middle of the court. Battle gives it to Wolf. She'll just take the three. Almost got it, but not quite. Climbing the ladder is Blackford for the flashes. She'll haul down the rebound. Modkins, nice crossover move down the lane. She'll kick to the far side. Opens up a three-pointer for Thal off the mark on the left side. Now this one led for Battle. A look at the basket. Nice job around the driving player there. That was Modkins trying to make the block for the Golden Flashes. But a patient play there from Battle.
Yeah, really good finish from Battle. Kept that ball up around her head until Modkins flew right by her. Able to put it up and in.
And now the RedHawks force a turnover. Blackford tried to put it into the post, but just a bit too high for Claire Kelly out of bounds. Both teams will make their substitutions. 2:25 to go. 27-18 our score. Kent State on top of Miami. Wolf takes it across the timeline. She'll call Scott to move towards her. Now Scott has the ball in her hands. Pass was partially tipped and now fired into the Kent State bench. Bit of a panic there in the lane for Jada Duckett, who picked up the loose ball on the floor and tried to give it to Wolf, but too far out of her reach. RedHawks provide a little bit of pressure, but easily circumvented by the Golden Flashes as they get this one across the timeline. Kelly, double team. Now Scott will pull out of it, just a one-on-one. Young has it in her hands now. She'll give it right back to Kelly. Flip to the far corner. Jab by Thal. Thought about coming across the court and said she'll pull back and fire the three. It's good. Some of those contested threes have really just fallen for Kent State all game long, and the lead is now 12. Now a try on the flip side for Wolf off the screen. The three-pointer no good. Rebound by Blackford. Now Santoro racing up the far side. She'll slow down. Santoro to the near flank. Put into the post by Kelly. Blackford trying to bully her way toward the basket. Just turned around and fired it on frame. It hit off the rim. Now the rebound tapped all over the place. Blackford ran all the way out to the top of the key to go get it off the floor. Santoro with the left hand. That hit off the underside of the backboard. Now the ball is tied up and it'll be a jump.
RedHawks with the possession arrow, it will stay with Miami.
1:05 to go in the second quarter. And now Todd Starkey wants an explanation. Duckett may have been able to get that rebound, but she just kind of bobbled it, and that allowed Blackford to race in and provide some contention for the loose ball. Now with 65 seconds remaining on the clock, the RedHawks will begin their possession, looking to cut this lead down. Currently stands at 12. Wolf to the near elbow. Passes it off for Davidson, who one-hands it down. Wolf has it now top of the key. Little isolation play. Finally gets it off the screen. Wolf moving down low. That was stripped from her grasp on the drive. Out of bounds. Possession will stay with the RedHawks. 8 to shoot, 44.9 left on the game clock. Quick inbound, battling toward the basket as Duckett got a good look, but just hit off the iron. RedHawks continue what has been a tremendous struggle shooting from the field throughout the entirety of this first half.
25.8% so far. That's 8 for 31, Luke. Really not great numbers.
The RedHawks have just not gotten those shots to fall. Kelly fires it down low. Blackford couldn't get the roll. Shot clock off now, and on the rebound, we get a foul.
Number 24, Peyton Scott with the personal foul.
That'll be the second on Peyton Scott. 17.1 seconds to go. And as mentioned before, the shot clock is off. Miami's going to rush in a last-second substitution. Sydney Watkins, the 5'8 redshirt freshman guard out of Indianapolis, will come in. So the RedHawks try to lock this down here at the end. Blackford had an open look, but instead she kicks outside for an open three. That one wouldn't go, though. Offensive rebound for the Flashes. 8 left on the game clock. Kelly passes to Santoro. Santoro can't find space. She'll dish off for Thal. Deep three, no good. And that is how we conclude our first half. So just kind of a claw your way forward first half for Kent State as they gradually extend their lead out through the opening 20 minutes. It stands at 12:30-18, our score. Jack, your thoughts on the opening two quarters?
Well, Luke, it really hasn't been a great game for Miami on either side of the ball, especially offensively. Like we just mentioned, they're shooting just 25.8% from the field, 2-for-8 from three. They have some turnovers too, 7 already in the first half. Definitely going to have to clean it up a little bit, try to make some more shots. They're actually doing a pretty good job getting to the hoop, especially Ivy Wolf in particular just can't get the lid off the rim. I think they're going to have to try and do a little better at that in the second half.
Yeah, and with those misses, it's just felt kind of dull for the RedHawks, not a whole lot of energy on the offensive side. So we'll see if Deanna Hendricks is able to make those changes in this halftime break that will bring the RedHawks back into this game. We'll take a short break here on RedHawk Radio, just about 15 minutes until the beginning of our second half. Until then, 30-18, our score. Kent State leads. You're listening to Miami Basketball here on RedHawk Radio. Luke Westpojack, Schmelzinger alongside back here for the second half of action between Kent State and Miami. Golden Flash is leading the RedHawks by a 30-18 score at the break. And Jack, you look at the halftime stats. We talked about it after that first half, really just a struggle shooting for the field for Miami, just 25.8%, 8 for 31, and they haven't really been able to get a whole lot going offensively through the opening 20 minutes.
Yeah, that's right. We saw some pretty stifling defense from Kent State in that first half, doing a really good job inside, keeping those RedHawks uncomfortable and really not giving them much space to shoot from outside either. Miami just going to have to get past that, start making some shots if they want to have a chance to win this one.
Absolutely, yeah. Kent State's been a fantastic defensive team all year long, and that hasn't changed here tonight. Golden Flashes haven't necessarily shot the ball exceptionally well, 32.4% from the field. However, 30.8%, 4 for 13 from beyond the arc, and they looked really, really good from deep, made some big shots in that first half. Really just some timely shooting from the Golden Flashes that allowed them to build that momentum and establish this lead. Team's getting ready for the second half of play. Once again, Miami trailing by 12. Golden Flashes will begin with possession here in the second half. Golden Flashes trying to get over the 500 hump in MAC play, currently standing at 8-8 in conference. Tied for sixth right now with Western Michigan and Bowling Green. They've only got three games left on the schedule in the regular season. They will head to Buffalo for a 1 o'clock start with the Bulls on Saturday. Then next Wednesday they'll be at Bowling Green. And then Saturday, March 5th, they will host Ohio in their final game of the regular season. On the Miami side, three games left as well. They'll host BG in a 2 o'clock start on Saturday. And they will head to Ohio for another edition of the Battle of the Bricks on Wednesday. That'll be a 7 p.m. start. And they will also conclude their season on March the 5th. Next Saturday, as they will take on Akron. That game will be at the Zips Place, and it will be a 2 o'clock start. 10 minutes up on the clock. Both teams break the huddles. Once again, Golden Flashes will begin with possession here in this second half. And they will move right to left from our perspective to begin this third quarter. Shoemate, the leading scorer in that first half, tied for the team lead, I should say, with 7 points, will inbound. Modkins controlling underway here in the third. Shoemate tried to drive down the lane but was pushed outside by Miami's Davidson. Now moseying across the court is Ogle. Passed in for Thal, who has a wide open lane to the basket, and that's an easy two. Lindsay Thal up to 9 points in the game. She was the other one tied with Shoemate for the team lead in points in the first half. 14-point Golden Flashes lead. Well, Miami, this is Wolf. Drives down the lane, falls to the court, able to slip it to Scott outside. Contested three is good. Peyton Scott was really trying hard that first half to get her legs under her, just couldn't really do so, but a big shot for her here early in this third.
That'd be huge for the RedHawks' chances if she can get hot, especially from outside the arc.
On the Kent State side, Modkins slips it into the post. Thal, turnaround shot near the basket, it'll draw the foul. Thal just threw it at the backboard, but she drew enough contact from Katie Davidson to earn a trip to the free throw line. Lindsay Thal is a 43% free throw shooter, and the first one is no good. Second shot up, and that one is cashed in by Thal. 12-point lead for Kent State, 8:48 to go in the third quarter. Wolf hands off to Scott. With her back turned at the free throw line, Foster Walker will now turn around. Just has to revert it back outside for Wolf. Top of the key, contested deep shot. That one is no good and falls into the hands of Blackford on the rebound. Modkins across the timeline. Crosses over Scott. Modkins dishes across, and that's an easy bucket there for Thal. A nice play by Modkins to create that open look. And all Thal had to do was lay it in right underneath the basket. Thal into double digits now. Contact there after the ball slipped loose from Eden Battle, and there's going to be a foul on Miami as Shoemate fell down to the court. Ivy Wolf will be called for the personal foul. That's her second.
Luke, Miami still has not been to the free throw line today. I think that that kind of confirms what I feels like we've both been seeing, just not a ton of tenacity from the RedHawks tonight getting to the rim.
Yeah, absolutely. A lot of their scoring has come from outside. We mentioned the struggle shooting the ball, but it's really just kind of been because a lot of their looks have come from that mid-range and even beyond the arc from three, and they haven't been getting them to fall, and obviously without a whole lot of drives to their name, haven't been able to get to the free throw line. Modkins holding on for Kent State. She'll hand off on the far side to Shoemate, who will make her way back towards the middle. Now Blackford with eight to shoot. Slips it into the high post. Thal back to Blackford. That pass was tipped away by Scott. Miami racing forward in transition. Scott gets it back. Contested mid-ranger. That one too strong. Saved from going out of bounds by Young. And now racing forward for Kent State is Modkins all the way to the basket. Too much momentum. That carried the ball over the rim. Miami with a chance now. Here's Scott. One hands it to the near side. Into the corner. Thinking about it and taking it is Battle, just a bit short on the three. Picked up by Shoemate for Kent State. She'll cross the timeline and now try to settle down. Looking for an option. She's double teamed. She'll hand that one off to Modkins, but the ball was tapped away from her by Battle, who's able to get it loose. And now wide open underneath the basket is Geralt for Miami. So a nice steal there by Battle, and Geralt picks up the fast break bucket. We got a whistle after Modkins fell to the court. Believe there may be some blood on her, so she's going to have to check out of the game. 6:56 to go. Kent State leading 35-23. Claire Kelly will come in for Kent State. And the junior guard out of Olmsted Falls will inbound. Miami putting together a little bit of a press, but Golden Flash is able to get around it. Underneath the basket, trying the reverse there was Blackford. She'll have to kick it back outside. Miami gives her nothing down low. Now a drive down the lane, an awkward pass there, but it worked out for Shoemate, who dished to Dunn and picked up the two. Turning around for Miami's Foster Walker. She's controlling at the top of the key. Now a pass and screen for Battle, which opens up a lane to the basket, but she can't get the layup to go. Rebound is Santoro for Kent State. Reverse to the near side. Dunn gives into the corner. Kelly's pass to Blackford was partially tipped. Blackford still able to corral it, and over top of Kluse, she's able to get the basket to go. Blackford has 5 points in this game, but has certainly made an impact in other aspects. We've called her name a lot tonight. On the Miami side, driving was Kluse. Her shot hit off the underside of the rim. Now going behind the back and getting around the traffic is Kelly. Down low, she hands it off to Dunn, but an offensive foul as Kelly mowed over a Miami defender.
The player control foul committed by number 20, Claire Kelly. Her second. The Flash's first of the third quarter. Reporting in right now for Kent State, number 44, Lindsay Thal. And for the Red Hawks, coming in number 13.
Lindsay Thal will come back into the game for Kent State. Ivy Wolf and Jada Duckett will check in for the Red Hawks. Wolf the point guard this time for Miami. Driving down low is Scott, able to get around the defender, but couldn't get the shot to go. Then on the rebound, she put her hands in there and drew a jump ball. Inbound coming up here for Miami. Pushed all the way to the near elbow. Wolf drives through the needle, but can't get the shot to go. Second try there from Duckett. We'll earn her a trip to the free throw line. J. Jada Duckett, averaging just about 5 points per game. Head to the free throw line. That's a place where she's really struggled this year. 32% shooter from the charity stripe. Santoro out, Modkins in for the Golden Flashes. And the first free throw is no good off the iron there from Duckett. Second try off the front iron. Miami fought for the rebound but couldn't get to it. It was picked off the floor by Shumate. Kelly holding on for the Flashes. 5:10 to go. Kelly turning around, heavily marked up by Scott, who was able to pry the ball free. Now it's loose on the court, and it hit off the foot of Scott, so it's going to be a kickball called on her, and possession will stay with the Flashes. A fortunate break there for Kitts.
Good hustle play by Peyton Scott, though. The senior is certainly not checking out toward the end of her final season, even though the RedHawks aren't having the best year.
Yeah, Scott was providing pretty heavy pressure there. Was almost rewarded with a steal, but just a bit too ambitious. Turning around, trying to push that back outside was Shumate, but it went right into the hands of Duckett for Miami. Scott, open three, yes. Peyton Scott with the tray, and Miami has a bit of life here. 13 points is the lead. A double team, barely able to get around it there was Modkins on the backhand. The pass down low was tipped into the corner. It's recovered by Dunn for the Flashes. Deep three is good from Thal, my goodness.
That's some serious range, impressive shot from Thal.
Yeah, Thal was almost at the logo and had a defender in her face and just tossed it up and it went right through.
Barely grazed net.
Miami trying to respond with a three of their own. That one just a bit short for Wolf. Rebound for the Golden Flashes. It finds Modkins. Modkins a nice crossover, but now we'll have to settle down. To the near elbow. Now it's floated into the post. Able to climb the ladder was done. Now this opens up a three look at the top of the key, and it's banked in by Modkins. Modkins, the 5'1 senior guard out of Solon, with a huge tray. And that will force Miami's hand once again. Deanna Hendricks calls T. 3:47 to go. And the Golden Flashes continue to roll a 19-point lead here in the third. 3:47 to go here in the third quarter. Kent State on top of Miami by 19. Golden Flash is on a pretty nice run right now. 45-26 our score. RedHawks looking to cut into a bit of this momentum with possession coming out of the Deanna Hendricks timeout. And out of that timeout, Ivy Wolf going to be the point guard for the RedHawks carrying up court. Wolf off the screen, drives down the lane on the near side. Turnaround shot is stuffed by Dunn.
There's a little bit of time left in this game, but Miami's going to have to start scoring some buckets. It's pretty tough to come back from a more than 10-point deficit in 10 minutes. Well, by that logic, they've got about 3 minutes to score 9 points and not let Kent State score any.
Yeah, Miami has certainly not really had that kind of string of buckets that have stuck together as we get a foul underneath the basket on the RedHawks, so it'll bring an inbound for the Golden Flashes. But yeah, in that first half, the RedHawks did not have a single time where they were able to get two baskets and a defensive stop in between. And so, I mean, this is kind of the result you'd expect with a stat line like that. And after that timeout, we're right back to media. So 3:11 to go. And I guess we'll send you to break. 45-26. Nothing has changed in the past 30 seconds, but we'll send you there anyway. Back in a moment, Miami Women's Basketball here on Red Hawk Radio. Kent State to inbound, 3:11 to go here in the third quarter. Underneath their basket, turning around there is Young, floats up a shot that never really got too close to the basket off the glass. Miami will pull down the rebound and race ahead. This is Battle all the way to the rack, and that's good. Eden Battle doing it herself. And Miami with a bit of momentum coming out of that timeout. Now for the Golden Flashes, Modkins trying to create space on the far side. Now she makes her way back toward the near side off the screen. She tried to pass it for Kelly, but just lost control of the basketball midway through, out of bounds off her hands, and a turnover. It'll go back to the RedHawks. Across the timeline for Miami, Ivy Wolf to the near elbow for Battle. Off the screen, RedHawks go around the horn to the far side. Now Battle has it back top of the key. Battle calls for the screen, 10 to shoot. She'll push that one into the paint. It was slapped away from Richeson and out of bounds, but it will stay with the RedHawks after the last touch from Kent State. That was Lindsay Thal who got her hand in there. Santoro will come in to replace Modkins. We've seen them flip-flop quite a bit tonight for Kent State. Two smallest players on this roster standing at 5'1 and 5'4. And with five to shoot, that one was just pushed out towards midcourt. It was barely recovered by Wolf, but she's got to just get something up, and she is stuffed by Thal. It will officially be a shot clock violation on Miami as the Golden Flashes weren't able to get possession before the shot clock expired, but Thal still shutting down any chance Miami had at the basket there.
Luke, Ivy Wolf having a pretty, well, just really not a great game from the field. She's 1 for 15 right now. It's interesting that the freshman is still out on the floor, but I kind of like it from Deanna Hendricks, showing that she has some confidence in her young star.
Yeah, she's coming off a career performance at Buffalo, tied her season high with 38 minutes and 22 points. But yeah, like you mentioned, she's created a lot of opportunities for herself tonight, just couldn't get the shots to go.
Yeah, that's a good point. She has really gotten to the rim quite a few times, and I mean, she's taken a lot of shots, and she hasn't been taking bad shots, so you have to say that she has been getting herself good opportunities. Like you said, just needs to get the lid off that rim.
Absolutely. So
glad to see her keep shooting, though.
Definitely, for sure. Following a Miami foul, it'll be an inbound for Kent State on the baseline. Into the corner, it's picked up by Shoemate. She makes her way toward the middle and lofts one up in the paint that is good. Nice play there from Katie Shoemate. And she's had quite an impact with 9 points in this game for Kent. Scott gives off to Kloos. She will drive and now kick. Top of the key, triple for Battle off the mark. Rebound comes all the way back out to her though, coming way out is Santoro. She will crash into Battle, and I believe this is going to be a foul on her.
Foul committed by number zero, Casey Santoro.
Will be on Santoro.
The third for the Flashes.
And that will be her second personal and the third team foul. Flashes are shooting the bonus, as the next foul will be the fifth for Miami here in the late goings of this third quarter, 1:18 to go. Kloos gives off to Wolf. 8 to shoot for Miami. Wolf tries to force it toward the baseline and in front of Richeson there for Kent State. That was Santoro who was able to tip it out of bounds. RedHawks need a catch and shoot here with 4 to shoot.
Miami Wolf to make other than try and force that thing down in the blocks.
Battle into the corner. Scott just has to throw it up quick and it airballed, so it'll be a shot clock violation on the RedHawks. Yeah, the RedHawks just seems like on every possession they kind of got one player that's trying to do everything, and it hasn't really worked out for them. Trying to play one on five, they haven't generated a whole ton of just great looks, especially in those high percentage areas down low.
Yeah, I think that's a really good observation. It really does look like they're trying to go one on five.
With 45 seconds to go, Flashes with an offensive possession underneath the pressure. Young tossed her arms up at the basket and drew the foul in the paint. That'll be on Richeson, her second foul. And it will send Young to the free throw line. Hannah Young, the 5'10 senior guard out of Forest, Virginia, started every game, including this one, for the Golden Flashes this season. Coming off a pretty solid performance, 23 minutes and 11 points against Bowling Green, and double figures in two of her last three. Hasn't quite matched that performance yet here today, but still quite a bit of time. 4 points for her this evening. She goes 2 for 2 from the line. 21-point lead for the Golden Flashes with 36 seconds remaining on the clock. Battle thought about it for quite a long time about taking the three. Instead, drove down low, put up a decent look, but off the glass, no good. Rebound for Shoemate. Now Santoro. spins away from Wolf. Now Wolf goes crashing down after the contact. Santoro whistle for the offensive foul.
On the reserve, facing center, the third. The fourth for KSU.
Miami to inbound on the near side. Tasia Foster Walker checks into the game. Shot clock off, 13 seconds to go in the third. Miami looking for the last shot, ball in the hands of Ivy Wolf. Wolf to the near side, battle. Fakes the shot, now drives down low. Tried to loft that one up away from the pressure, it wouldn't go. Now a big shot from Shoemate. That one is well short though on the buzzer beater attempt, and that ends the third quarter. So the team on the road continues to roll. The lead extended for Kent State in the third frame. 49-28 our score, Jack. Not a whole lot to be said that we haven't already talked about through the third 10-minute quarter. Just a whole lot of Kent State right now.
Yeah, a lot of Kent State. Miami not even on pace to score 40 points in this one. I wonder when the last time that happened is. Kent State really just not even sweating here. And I don't remember the last time I watched a basketball game where I saw a team struggle as much on offense as Miami has tonight.
Yeah, you mentioned Todd Starkey's teams after not giving up more than 70 points all season long did it in the last two games, and those two games snapped a six-game win streak. Flashes coming into tonight's definitely some adjustments. That was definitely discussed in film, I'm sure, in the past week or so, and the Flashes have definitely made good on that promise to their coach. A fantastic game defensively as they head into the fourth quarter. We'll take a short break here on Red Hawk Radio. Final frame on the way. Kent State on top. They are rolling up 49-28. Final frame on the way here from Millett Hall. Kent State leading Miami 49-28 after 30 minutes of play. Golden Flash is looking to get over 500 in MAC play, currently standing at 8-8 on the season as they make their way into the home stretch. Flash has started off with possession, and right away a reach-in foul for Ivy Wolf of Miami. That'll bring an inbound on the far side for Kent. For the Golden Flashes, they held a lead at halftime and extended it quite a bit. Definitely the best quarter of basketball we saw from them all evening long in that third. And the lead currently stands at 21. Blackford had the ball pried loose from her grasp, lifted up into the air. It was picked down by Wolf, who will move across the timeline now for Miami. Wolf to the near side, lifts it over everybody, and there's a nice play. Santoro will hand off to Shoemate. Shoemate runs across the court, met with resistance from Clues. Now releases to Santoro. Santoro backs off the pressure, now drives and turns around with seven to shoot. That was a great play, but couldn't get the shot to go. Scott with one hand, maybe a little too fancy there, taken away by Santoro. Scott was trying to pass it across the court and transition to Ivy Wolf, but Santoro intercepts. Nearly a backcourt there as Santoro lost it, marked up by Wolf, but she was able to recover. 15 to shoot. Santoro now covered by Scott, who pries that one loose and takes it away. 2-on-1 for Miami. Bounce down low and with the right hand finished off by Clues.
That's by far the two easiest buckets we've seen for the RedHawks tonight.
So the lead now back down to 17 for Kent. And now we're going to get a jump ball and Miami with the possession arrow. So the RedHawks building a bit of momentum here. 8:15 to go in this fourth quarter. Still quite a ways to go, of course, but something in terms of life that we haven't really seen all game long yet.
Yeah, that's for sure. And even if this game might be out of reach on the scoreboard, I'm not sure if it is. I think they still do have a chance to maybe come back. Definitely good to see the RedHawks, like you said, show some life, get a little bit of momentum on their side, something we literally have not seen all night.
Yeah, absolutely. I think that's a great point. The RedHawks have just seemed kind of dull all night long, but maybe piecing something together here in the late goings. A drive down the lane with the right hand. That was too far over the top. Foster Walker got the rebound and crashed down hard. A foul will be called, but a dangerous play there underneath the basket. Good to see Foster Walker get up right away. RedHawks will inbound from the baseline. Geraltz will get us going. Into the corner, this is Fulton. Scott picks it out of the air, able to shield it off from Kelly. Top of the key. To the far side now, Wolf at the elbow. Back for the near play, pulling up from the free throw line with seven to shoot is Scott, no good.
It's honestly a surprise to see her miss that shot. She almost always hits that pull-up jumper from the free throw line. It's just like muscle memory to expect that thing to go down.
Yeah, that one was really close, mm-hmm. but just in and out for Scott. Yeah, like you said, Jack, those shots, they seem to go in all season long for her, but just not tonight.
Yeah, seriously.
Three-pointer missed there by Kent. That was Thal who tried the triple. Now Scott will try one of her own, and this one is good. So Scott knocks it down from the top of the key, and now the lead is down to 14.
And all of a sudden, she seems so quiet all night. Well, she already has 15 points.
My goodness. Yeah, she's really flown under the radar. Hasn't been super impactful in terms of energy for the RedHawks, but like you said, quietly made her way into the double digits. Mm-hmm. Shot missed. RedHawks looking to make them pay. Transition three, no good for Wolf, and the rebound pulled down by Dunn. Modkins holding on top of the key for Kent. She'll mosey toward the far side. Tried to beat Geraltz to the corner, but didn't do so, so she'll give it back to the top of the key for Shoemate. Shoemate trying to bash her way toward the basket, just put up a shot that went directly off the front of the rim. Rebound by Scott. Scott thought about potentially taking the drive and said pull back and tried a second time, and she draws the foul.
The foul committed by number 14, Katie Shoemate, her third. The team's
Shoemate picks up her third. Now Peyton Scott will head to the free throw line. Substitutions for the RedHawks. Looks like it'll be Richeson and Battle back into the game, as well as Clues. She's a late substitution coming in for Tiana Fulton. Peyton Scott will shoot two. She's an 85% free throw shooter. And the first free throw is good. Scott had 19 points in the last game against Buffalo, 30-plus minutes for the last four games. That shows how much the RedHawks really lean on her. She had 37 minutes in the game against the Bulls last week. Second free throw is good, and now the lead cut down to 12. Thal puts it into the middle for Kelly, who can race it across the timeline. Kelly will pull back, 5:57 to go in the game. Modkins top of the key, reverted to the far side, driving is Thal, marked up by Scott, plays it into the paint, and that's an easy bucket. There, that's Hannah Young. And I believe Kent State's going to call a timeout there, and they are. It's going to be a 30-second timeout, I believe. So we'll keep you here for that. 51-37, our score. And Kent State able to break up a little bit of that Miami momentum that was built up over the past couple of minutes, but especially with a lead like this and so little time left on the clock, just trying to take as much time away from the RedHawks on the offensive side as they can.
Yeah, and Miami really doesn't have much room at this point, really, or any room for errors or even to let Kent State score. They're going to have to put up a few points in a row if they want to have a chance to come back in this one, but even if they can't, it would be great to see them play some good basketball in the last 5 minutes or so. They've had a lot better start to the fourth quarter than they were through the rest of the game.
Absolutely, yeah. Struggle for the RedHawks, but we've kind of seen flashes throughout tonight from Miami, and that has never really materialized into anything big as they've fallen behind pretty significantly in this one. But certainly some moments for the RedHawks where they were playing good basketball and they strung together a couple decent possessions.
Yeah, and I think it's a testament to how well they've played defensively tonight that, you know, even now they're a couple of threes away from really being right back in this game. When you hold a team to 50 or 60 points in a night, you're usually putting yourself in a really good position to win.
Yeah, this is a completely different game from the one that we saw back in Kent. That was on February 7th, just about 2 weeks ago. The Flashes took that one in a shootout, 83-61. Nyla Blackford led them on that night with 22 points. That was her season high. Crown Charter, they're ready to go. Are you? Once again, 5:46 left in the fourth quarter. Kent State currently with a possession arrow. Foul's not too much of a factor right now for either team. Miami with one team foul here in this fourth. Kent State with two.
Yeah, and it seems like it, I don't know if you'd agree with this, but it seems like we've had a little bit of just kind of a lower energy game, at least a lower energy second half. I think that those foul numbers really kind of prove that the just not a ton of hard drives into the paint, I think, is really where we're seeing a little bit of a lack of energy here tonight.
No, I'd agree 100%. Yeah, it's kind of been a lot of perimeter play, and Kent State has knocked down some threes, but even those deep twos, those have had their place in this game as well. There just hasn't been a lot of play at the rim, and when it's been there, it's just kind of been battling for loose balls instead of putting shots up at the basket. And so, yeah, it's been mostly the shot chart has been dotted kind of from the outside.
Yeah, you wonder, maybe they've been watching a lot of Bulls basketball. We've seen DeMar DeRozan kind of a resurgence of the mid-range shot this year, and it's been working for the Bulls, working tonight for Kent State.
Kent State, their game is solid defense, and they've got some shooters on their squad as well, with quite a few members of their team shooting in the 40s and 50s from the field. Finally coming out of that timeout, RedHawks will have possession, 5:43 and counting to go. Geralts to the near elbow for Battle. Off the screen, Battle makes her way to the top of the key before passing off to Scott. Scott now pulls up from the free throw line, there it is. We saw her miss from a similar position earlier, but not this time. Peyton Scott makes no mistake. Thal gives it to the top of the key. Modkins maybe could have shot it, but instead she'll just settle this one down to take some more time. Approaching 5 minutes to go here in regulation. Blackford to the near elbow for Young. Now a deep three taken there. Rebound popped up high in the air. And we're going to get a foul on Miami called. Kelly tried the triple. And it hit the back part of the rim, which shot the ball up in the air, and the RedHawks will be called for the foul while the teams are battling for the rebound. In the lane, this one's pushed back outside for Kelly. Now Blackford trying to get her way toward the basket, but she stuttered in a traveler's call. Well, RedHawks with a chance to maybe cut this one down into single digits on this possession. Geraltz gives to Scott. Around the screen, one-handed to the near side for Battle. Battle trying to drive, gets around it. Not a great shot up though. Battle trying to save it, and she could not.
Once again in this game, the RedHawks get to the rim, just not able to get that ball to fall, especially Battle and Ivy Wolf tonight have done that a bunch of times. You have to think this game would be, I mean, at least a little bit closer if they were able to get a little, few more of those layups to fall.
Yeah, the RedHawks have created a few looks down low, but like you said, Jack, just haven't been able to finish. Turning away from the pressure there as Modkins opened up a lane to the basket, and she was blocked, but a foul call. Believe this one's going to be on Geraltz. And it will be. That'll be her fourth personal, so she's in a bit of trouble here with 4:21 to go, and that will send Mariah Modkins, a 75% free throw shooter, to the charity stripe. Substitution for the RedHawks, Geraltz out and Ivy Wolf back in. And the first free throw right through for Modkins. Free throw number two good as well. Wolf with the ball in her hands for Miami. To the far wing, Scott. Crossing back and forth. Threads the needle off the glass, just a bit too high. Picked up by Young. She has some trouble at the timeline. It was pulled from her grasp by Scott. Went into the scorer's table. Possession will go to the Flashes. Settled down by Thal. Off the inbound, Modkins now controlling. Under 4 minutes to play, 3:55 and counting here from Millett Hall. Kent State leading Miami by a 53-39 score. Modkins trying to get some progress at the basket, does so finally, but then dishes off into the corner for Blackford. Blackford now turning in the paint, and it's going to be a foul called on the RedHawks. And they're going to count the basket. So the whistle came pretty early in that sequence for Blackford down low, but she finished the play and put up a shot. It was a layup that was good. They're going to give her the basket, and now a chance to make it and one. And the free throw rolls home for Blackford. Lead back out to 17 points for Kent. Scott looking for an option. On the far wing. In one-on-one with Blackford. She'll cross and now pull up from mid-range, and that one nowhere close, well short. May have been partially tipped. Flashes will move it quickly across the timeline and now settle down with Modkins. Trying to get her hands in there as Wolf to create the steal, but Modkins shields her off from that. Kent bleeding this shot clock away. 3:03 to go on the game clock. Blackford in the high paint. Now a deep three, and it's cashed in by Thal. My goodness.
Third long one she sunk tonight.
Yeah, absolutely. That's
or second, rather.
Another deep three for Thal. Those are shots some people don't even think about taking, but Thal has decided to do it two times tonight, and she has made them both. 30-second timeout called by Miami. We'll keep you here for this one, 2:53 to go. And the lead is back out to 20 points for the Golden Flashes. Lindsay Thal, 6'2 senior forward out of Strongsville. Two-time MAC All-Defensive Team selection. Had no points in the last game against Bowling Green.
Really?
But quite an impact, 18 today for the Golden Flashes.
Yeah, when you have a MAC Defensive Player of the Year candidate stepping back and hitting shots, hitting step-back threes in people's faces, that's a really dangerous player. She's been a big part of the Kent State winning effort here tonight. Type of player that any coach would like to have on the floor for her.
Huge rebound game for Lindsay Thal. Out of the timeout, RedHawks with possession. Wolf across the timeline. Scott on the near wing. Threads the needle down low with the left hand. That shot just never got to rim height, and it's tipped out of bounds. Last touch from Miami.
That's been a lot of the shots, I think, tonight for Miami, just not getting to rim height. A lot of them, you know, off the side of the rim or the bottom of the backboard or even the side of the backboard as Miami intercepts a pass.
Yeah, Kent State tried a little Hail Mary play there coming out of the baseline inbound, but the RedHawks were ready for it. Battle will mow a defender over. That was Young. It'll draw the charge. That's the fourth personal on Battle. Puts Kent State into the bonus with 2:34 to go. Miami providing some pressure here in the backcourt, and Scott gets the steal. At the last moment, a foul is called. It's going to be on the flashes, though. Foul will be on Blackford after she lost possession of that one. Scott finally getting that steal she'd been searching for so long.
Number 12, Jenna Batch, replacing Hannah Young.
Jenna Batch will make her first appearance. 6-foot freshman forward out of Loveland, Ohio, Loveland High School. Played for the Tigers. Nice little play off the back there that was picked up by Ivy Wolf, but now it'll go back the Golden Flash's way after the shot was missed.
Yeah, a really smart play by Ivy Wolf there, or at least the beginnings of one, but just not her night. 1-for-16 from the field, a late turnover there. And you have to imagine she probably just can't wait to get back to her dorm room right now.
That'll send Blackford to the line as they'll move the two squads all the way across the court to the Kent State side. Flash's lead stands at 20 points. Now checking into the game will be Anna Pavlonsky, 6-foot senior utility player at Cortland, Ohio, making her first appearance in 1 week. Missed the game against Buffalo, or BG rather, as well as the Akron game. Her last appearance came against Northern Illinois back on February the 16th. First free throw was good for Blackford. The second one on the way, and it rolls off the rim and out. Picked up by Clues for Miami. She will carry up court. Maddie Clues hands off to Peyton Scott. Scott around the screen. Didn't get much of anything. Will dish off for Clues. She'll drive with the left hand. It rolls around and in. Maddie Clues with 4 points this evening. Peyton Scott continuing to apply pressure, but Kelly able to force her to the court. Now RedHawks force a steal, though, as it's taken away by Battle. Nothing but daylight in front of her. She'll bury it.
Maybe the RedHawks should have been in this full court press a little bit earlier, starting to put some pressure on the flashes, and they really can't handle it.
And Batch turns it over now, and the RedHawks get yet another, this time off the hands of Peyton Scott. Lead still stands at 15 for Kent, but yeah, like you said, Jack, this full court press really working for the RedHawks. Finally, Kent able to get around it on this possession, and they will get it across the timeline and give it back to Santoro, who will kill some time. Pavlonsky twisting and turning. Stepping in her way was Wolf, and she'll be whistled for the foul.
The foul is on Miami's number 13, Ivy Wolf. Her fourth.
That's the fourth foul on Ivy Wolf.
Coming in right now for Kent State, number 43, Bexley Wallace.
Bexley Wallace will make her first appearance.
At the line, shooting.
6'3 redshirt junior out of Pickerington, Ohio, suburban Columbus. Pavlonsky at the line. Can't knock down the first free throw. That's her first attempt of the season. Now the second try is up, and this one is good. Scott will touch it after it crosses the timeline to begin the clock. 108 and counting. Scott down low with the and one.
Basket by Peyton Scott. A personal foul committed by number 20,
Sometimes Scott just does it herself on the offensive possessions, and there she let the ball roll across half court, picked it up, made a quick drive toward the basket, and now a chance for a three-point play at the line.
Yeah, and like a minute and a half ago, it looked like the RedHawks might not even score 40 points. They've got 47 now after that 8-1 run in the last minute and 18 seconds around right now.
RedHawks were really searching for that all game long as the free throw is good from Scott. They just never really found it, and now after the game was at hand, RedHawks were finally able to get some life.
Yeah, too little, too late.
Santoro across the timeline. Under a minute to play now. Santoro threads the needle, but the shot hits off the underside of the rim. Wolf for Miami spins with the left hand. It's good. And now a timeout called by Todd Starkey. This game is at hand with just 51 seconds left, but his team has kind of fell asleep in the last minute as Miami has almost cut this one to single digits.
Yeah, now it's an 11-2 run in the last minute and 59 seconds, and really glad to see one fall for Ivy Wolf. She is now 2 for 18. You just can only imagine how frustrating this game must have been for the freshman, but glad to see her get so much run late in this one, even though she's struggling, and I think she's going to be a really good player for the RedHawks for years to come.
Yeah, like you mentioned in our open, Jack, there were a lot of young players in the starting lineup for the RedHawks. The only senior starter for Miami was, of course, Peyton Scott. But now, with 51 seconds to go, Kent will inbound on the near sideline.
Luke, remember when Tracy McGrady scored 18 points in 53 seconds?
I do.
RedHawks just need a little of that magic right now. Maybe Peyton Scott. She's got a little T-Mac in her.
Need a quick steal. Santoro just trying to shield the ball off right now. She'll hand it off to Kelly. Now Bexley Wallace. Able to thread between a few Miami defenders, but now they all get their hands tied up in a jump ball. Guess who's got the possession arrow, though? It's not Miami.
Oh. I don't even know how that thing works because Miami's had it like three times in a row.
Kent State will inbound with 11 to shoot. Santoro gets it and pushes it back outside for Pavlonski. Pass too high for Santoro as she got it back. It's taken away by the RedHawks. Shot clock off with 20 seconds to go. Nice individual effort there, threading the needle. Ivy Wolf, she'll pick up two more.
She just had to get one to fall. And
Wolf with 6 points. She shot enough to maybe get 15 or 20, but
yeah,
just not her night. Across the timeline goes Casey Santoro. Clock winding down with the shot clock off. That's all we need to put a cap on this one. Clock will hit double zeros. And Kent State comes to Oxford and picks up a dominant road victory. Maybe not as close as the scoreboard shows as the RedHawks put together a late run. Final in this one, 61-52. But if you're Todd Starkey, you got to be happy with about 38 minutes of how your team played in this one.
Yeah, absolutely. A really good performance from Kent State, especially on the defensive end. Really not letting Miami get any good shots off inside and doing a great job getting hands in the faces of those Miami shooters on those long-range bombs. Held Miami to 39 points through 38 minutes. Like you said, they scored 14 in about the last minute and a half, but a really dominant defensive performance from Kent State and the RedHawks. A little something to build on there at the end, too.
So Kent State will improve to 17-9 on the season, 9-8 in MAC play for Deanna Hendricks, Miami RedHawks. They will fall to 8-18 on the year, 4-13 in the MAC. Miami with a chance to rebound back here at Millett Hall in a 2 o'clock start against Bowling Green. So until then, that'll conclude our coverage here from Red Hawk Radio for my great partner Jack Schmelzinger. Doing everything good today, from tech to running back to the dorm room for supplies. Luke Westpoli saying so long. Kent State wins it 61-52. This has been a presentation of Miami basketball here on Red Hawk Radio.